We were just talking about you.
Bert's on his way. Where's Roger?
Probably taking another Grecian treasure out of its crate.
I apologize for Baltimore. It has to be done.
Well, it's a sales call. Isn't there more I can do here?
It's not a sales call. You're the face of our business.
They need someone they can trust.
London fog. How ludicrous.
Really? I have one.
So do I.
No, of course. It's just the name. There is no fog in London. There is no London fog.
Are you sure about that?
Quite. Never was. It was the coal dust from the industrial era. Charles Dickens and whatnot.
Mr. Cooper, Mr. Pearson is here to see you.
Come on in, Bert.
Hey, Don.
Bert? Lane?
We need you to have a seat, Bert.
Okay. You got a blindfold, too? This isn't easy.
It really isn't.
Oh, God. I really thought I'd made it.
I know it's unkind, but it's generous and it's fair.
So why the hell did you wait so long?
It was brought to our attention that your wife was undergoing radiation. We thought it decent to wait.
That was decent.
Sorry I'm late. Did I miss anything? Oh, it's that meeting. Sorry about that. Wasn't easy.
We'll see how you do without my Rolodex.
We're going to take that risk.
You make me sick. You're the dying empire. We're the future.
Bert, control yourself.
I'm the head of accounts, damn it!
I'm sure we'll regret it. I'm serious.
See you on the breadlines, fellas.
Is that the last of it? Because I don't like how much I'm getting used to these.
I don't know anything you don't know.
Do you understand there's no point ever in making over $40,000 when you'll be taxed 69%? You're working for them. And God forbid you really make it, everything over 70 grand is 81%.
Even if you're married.
Fellow comrades in mediocrity, I want you to listen very carefully. You can all go straight to hell.
I heard he's going in-house at Nabisco. Nice to see you, Peggy.
Bert?
We're a long way from Sterling Cooper. Looks like the worm has turned.
Well, it's nice to have the old team back together.
Do you want me to get that?
Yes. Hello.
Oh. I was expecting a secretary. There isn't one on the line, is there?
Hold on. I've got to take this.
Well, we'll have plenty of time to catch up on those flights to Detroit. He's still a cold fish.
Come on in, Bert. Have a seat.
What is this? A bed?
Yeah. You might want to lie down, because here we are again.
Well, I haven't forgotten anything. Not a damn thing.
A lot of times in life, you get to do something, and you don't realize until it's over how much you enjoyed it. And you swear that the next time it comes around, you're going to remember that.
You're right. And I think I could work with you, too.
Work? No, Bert. I'm letting you go again.
What the hell? You can't do that.
Probably doesn't make a difference at this point, but no one fought for you.
Well, we'll see what the folks in Chevy have to say about this.
Remember Ken Cosgrove? Like a 6-foot version of Alan Ladd?
He's touring the plant right now.
You bastard. I've got 4 million in Billings. What have you got?
I was thinking you would feel that way. That you had more clients and that gives you a voice. I was imagining you talking over me in meetings. Now I don't have that problem.
My clients will leave with me.
No one will ever say you weren't funny, Bert.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. I'm expecting some kind of severance.
Who knows? We're really hurting. We're having to cut back. Well, obviously.
You're a real prick, you know that?
Damn it, Bert. You stole my goodbye.
Oh, hello. You must be Bert Peterson. I'm Bob Benson. I'm supposed to report to you.
Well, as a first order of business, I recommend that you stick your head between your legs and kiss your ass goodbye.